understand. You're healthy. Your father's not rich, but he's not poor. I earn only my life is much harder than yours. I earn only 23 rubles a month, and from that they deduct the pension fund. But I don't wear mourning.
It is not a matter of money. Even a poor person can be happy.
That's a nice theory, but in practice it doesn't work. Take my case. There's me, my mother, my two sisters, and my little brother. And on my salary of 23 rubles a month, we all have to eat and drink and buy tea and tobacco and so on and so on.
The play will begin soon.
Yes. The Insurrection is to perform a play by Constantine Garvillage. They're in love. Tonight their souls will mingle in art true to both of them. But your soul and my soul have no such common ground. Each day I walk 6 miles here and 6 miles back to meet nothing but indifference on your part. And I suppose it's to be expected. I have no private means and a big family. Who are married men that can't provide?
Nonsense. I'm touched by your love, but I can't choose on it. Here, have some snuff.
Oh, thank you, I don't want any.
What did you philosophize to talk about money? You think there is nothing worse than to be poor? I would 1,000 times prefer to be a beggar in rags than to... You wouldn't understand.
For some reason, don't ask me why, my dear. The country is just not my style. It's not. It's too late to change me now. Hey, last night I went to bed at 10. This morning I woke up at 9. All that sleep has glued my brain to my skull. It has. And then I fell asleep again after lunch. I'm a wreck. Stuck in a nightmare. Do you understand all the feeling?
You should be living in town. You two shouldn't be here. You'll be called when you're ready, but please leave now.
Masha, please, ask your father not to tie up the dog at night and get my sister away again.
You would have to ask him yourself. I won't ask him. And please don't ask me to ask him. Let's go.
Don't forget to call us when the play starts.
That means the dog won't be howling all night again. You see, I never get my way in the country. Ever since I decided to come here on 28th late day leave to rest and so on, and immediately I get here, they pester me with all sorts of nonsense. So right away I would want to leave. Leaving was always the best part. Now I'm retired, no place to go and so on. So, like it or not, I'm here.
Constantine Gavrilovich? We're going first.
All right. We'll be back in 10 minutes. It's almost time.
Yes.
This is our theater. The curtains wings from beyond. Empty space, no scenery. All you see is the lake and the horizon. The curtains go up at 8:30 just when the moon is rising.
Perfect.
But if Nina's late, of course, the whole effect would be spoiled. She should be here by now. Her father and stepmother watch you like hawks. It's hard for her to escape from home as from a prison. Your hair and beard are a mess. You should have them trimmed.
It's the bane of my life. Ever since I was young, I always looked like I was drunk or something. Women were never attracted to me. Why is your mother in such a bad mood today?
Why? She's bored. She's jealous. She's angry about my play because Nina's acting in it. She's not. She hasn't seen or read it, but she hates it.
Is that really true?
Yes. She's angry in advance because even though it's just on this little stage, it'd be Nina's success and not hers. She's a psychological case, my mother. Certainly talented and smart. Cry over a book and recite the whole of the crosses by heart. And when you're sick, she'll nurse you like an angel. But just try praising dudes around her.
Oh, no.
Not that. You may praise only mother. You may write only about productions mother's in. You may rave only about mother's performance in Camille and the Fumes of Life. And she's a miser. got 70,000 in the Bank of Odessa. I know this for a fact. But you ask her for a loan, and she'll burst into tears.
You think your mother doesn't like your play or something? Don't worry. Your mother adores you.
She loves me. She loves me not. She loves me. She loves me not. She loves me. She loves me not. You see? My mother doesn't love me. Why should she? No, she wants excitement and romance and pretty clothes. I'm 25 now. That reminds her she's no longer young. When I'm not around, she's 32. And when I am, she's 43. And she hates me for it. And because I don't believe in the theater. She adores the theater. She believes she's serving mankind in the sacred cause of art. You know, I think theater today is boring and trite. Each play repeats the same formula with tiny variations.
But we must have the theater.
What we need is a new kind of theater. We need new forms. If you can't have them, you have no theater at all. I love Mother. I love her very much. But she leads a stupid life. Always fussing about that writer of hers. Always trying to get her name in the paper. It's boring. And maybe I'm selfish, but I wish my mother weren't a famous actress. I wish she was just an ordinary mortal. Can you imagine what life is like with her uncle? The house always full with famous actors and writers. Can you imagine how I feel? The only nobody there is me. And who am I, her son? That's the only reason why they talk to me. When my mother's famous actor, writer, and musician friends deign to notice me, I feel them measuring my insignificance, and I imagine their thoughts. It's humiliating.
By the way, what sort of fellow is this writer of hers? I mean, I don't understand. He really never opens his mouth.
He's intelligent, simple, rather melancholy. He seems decent. He's under 40 and famous. He's got everything he wants. You know, as for his writing, while you can say it's charming and clever. But after reading Tolstoy or Zola, you hardly want to read to Gorn.
I love literary people. You know, in my life, I want two things passionately, to marry and to become a writer. Neither happened. So to be even a second-rate writer sounds pretty good to me.
Someone's coming. Oh, I can't live without her. Oh. Even the sound of her footsteps is beautiful. I'm wildly happy. My darling, what a dream.
I'm not late. I hope I'm not late.
No.
Oh, I worried all day. I was so afraid Father wouldn't let me come. He and my stepmother just went out. I raced the horse. The sky's already red. The moon will be up soon. But I'm happy now. I'm here.
You've been crying. I can tell from your pretty eyes. That won't do. It's really warm.
I'm all right now. Just out of breath. Please, let's hurry. I have to leave in a half an hour. I have to. Please don't ask me to stay any longer. I can't. My father doesn't even know that I'm here.
It's time. I'll call them.
Uncle, I'm going already. The friends, we're returning to the reality. You know, once when I started to sing like that, an assistant prosecutor said to me, "Your Excellency has a strong voice." Then he stopped and thought of this and added, "Strong, but not very."
My father and his wife forbid me to come here. They say it's Bohemia. But I'm drawn here to this lake like a seagull. My heart is filled with you.
We're alone.
That's someone over there.
No, there's no one.
What kind of tree is this?
It's a book tree.
Why does it look so dark?
It's evening. It's darker now. Please don't go away, Irina. Please don't.
I must.
No. I'll follow you home. I'll stand all night in the garden looking up at your window.
No, don't. The watchman would see you. And Treasure doesn't know you yet. He'd bark.
I love you.
Shh.
Who is that? Is that you, Yakov?
Yes, sir.
Do you have the mentholated spirits? Is the sulfur ready? When the red eyes appear, there must be a smell of sulfur.
Yes, sir.
Everything's ready. Are you nervous? You better go.
Yes, terribly. It's not your mother that I'm worried about. I'm not afraid of her. But Trigorin will be here. A famous writer. I'm terrified of acting in front of him. Is he young?
Yes.
What marvelous stories he writes.
I wouldn't know, I haven't read them.
You know, your play is hard to perform. There are no people in it.
Well, why should there be? I don't want to show life as it is or tell people how things should be. I want to show life in dreams.
But almost nothing happens. It's just talk. And I think there should always be lovers in a play. Oh, it's getting damp. Go back and put on your galoshes.
I'm too hot.
If you don't take care of yourself, you're so stubborn. Well, you're a doctor, you know perfectly well damp air is bad for you. But you want me to suffer. You sat on the terrace the whole of yesterday evening on purpose.
You're
so busy talking to Irina Nikolaevna that you didn't even notice the cold. Admit, you find her attractive.
I'm 55!
So what? For a man that's not old, you're still handsome. Women still like you.
What do you want me to do?
Men, they always throw themselves to the feet of an actress. Always.
Everyone loves actors. We think of them differently than, say, shopkeepers. It's natural. It's idealizing.
Ah. Women always fall in love with you. They throw themselves at you. Is that idealizing, too?
Maybe. There's some good in the feelings women have for me. What they love is that I'm a good doctor. 10 or 15 years ago, I was the only good doctor in the county. And I'm a decent
person. Oh, what a dear one, too, my darling.
Yeah, somebody's coming.
At the Bordeaux affair in 1873, she was wonderful. Fantastic. A sheer delight. And would you happen to know, dear lady, what happened to that actor, Shatin? That is Pavel Samuilovich Shatin. His Raskolnikov was better than Sadovsky. Where is he now?
Stop asking me about those actors from before the flood. How should I know where he is?
Yes, Pavel Shatin. There's no one like him anymore. There were mighty oaks in those days, now they're only stumps.
The general level of acting is higher.
I couldn't agree, sir, but this is a matter of taste. A gustibo, a bene, yari.
Dearest son, when will it start?
In a moment, please be patient.
Oh, Hamlet, speak no more. That haunts my eyes into my very soul, and there I see such dark and grated spots as will not bleed when they tink.
Bravo! Nay, but to live in wickedness, to seek love in the depth of sin. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. The play is about to begin. It begins now. Oh, ancient shades that by night fly over this lake. Lull us asleep now and bring us dreams of what will be in 200,000 years.
In 200,000 years, what will be is nothing.
Well, then let us show us that nothing.
Yes, let them. We sleep.
Men and beasts, lions, eagles, and partridges, antlered deer, mute fishes dwelling in the water. These and all life have run their sad course and are no more. Thousands of creatures have come and gone since there was life on earth. In the meadows, the cranes wake and fly no longer, and the beetles hum. Is silent. Shh. In the linden grove, all is cold, cold, cold. Empty, empty, empty. Desolate, desolate, desolate. The bodies of all beings are dissolved into dust. Eternal matter has changed them into stones and water and clouds. Their souls are merged into one, into me. I am the spirit of the world. In me lives the soul of Alexander the Great, of Caesar, Shakespeare, Napoleon, and of the lowest worm.
This is something definite.
I am alone. Every 100 years I open up my lips to speak, but my voice echoes sadly in the void. No one hears me, not even you, Cal Flames. The decay of the marsh spawns you late in the night, and you flicker without thought or will or feeling, but afraid what may be born from you. Satan, father of eternal matter, you and the stones and the water continuously change. Only I, spirit of the world, remain unchanged. I am eternal. I am like a prisoner, deep down an empty well. I don't know who I am or what awaits me. I only know that in the savage struggle between Satan, Prince of Matter, I shall ultimately win. Then, when spirit and matter merge harmoniously and become one, the reign of universal will shall begin. Until then, horror, horror, Satan, my mighty enemy approaches. I see his terrible blood-red eyes.
His little sword, is that part of his blade?
Yes.
Oh, I see sitting in bed.
Mother.
Without humans, Satan is lonely.
Oh, you've taken off your hat. But if that bunny catch cold,
shh.
The doctor is taking his hat off to save him, the father of eternal life.
The play is over. That's enough. That's enough curtain.
Why
are you angry? Go to the garden, curtain! I forgot that only a chosen few will permit his right plays or act in them have infringed on a monopoly. You. I?
What's the matter with him?
You can't hurt a young man's pride like that.
What did I say?
You hurt his feelings.
He said this play was to be for our amusement. I simply took him at his word.
Yes, but...
And now, it seems he's written a masterpiece.
Good Lord! He's concocted this whole performance, fumigating us with sulfur, not as entertainment, but as a lesson. He also teaches how to write and how to act. I'm sick of it. It's boring. His perpetual fury at me would wear out the patience of a saint. He's nothing but a capricious, conceited boy.
He only wants to please you.
Is that so? Then why can't he write something ordinary, instead of forcing us to listen to that depraved rubbish?
Well, I don't mind listening to rubbish occasionally if it's entertaining.
But this is pretentious of being a new form of art, a new era in art.
Well, I see nothing new in it. I see nothing. but the expression of a spiteful mind.
Everyone writes as they want and as they can.
Well, let him write what he wants and what he can. But don't ask me to listen to it.
Oh, Great Jove is angry.
I'm not Great Jove. I'm a woman. And I'm not angry. I'm just sorry to see a young man waste his time. I didn't mean to hurt his feelings.
There's no scientific basis for separating spirit from matter. After all, spirit just might be a different combination of atoms. I really wish somebody would write a play about a school teacher. He lived a very hard life. Very hard.
Oh, let's talk about something else, shall we? What a beautiful evening. Listen, do you hear? They're singing, it's lovely.
It's coming from the other side of the lake.
Come sit next to me. 10 or 15 years ago, there was a music and singing here by the lake almost every night. People along the shore were firing guns, making love. And the idol of all six houses, the Don Juan of it all, was our doctor here. Evgeny Sergeyevich! Well, he's charming now. But then, you're simply irresistible. My conscience beginning to bother me. Oh, why did I hurt my poor boy's feelings? I feel badly. Kostya! Darling Constantine!
I will go look for you.
What you, my dear?
Yuhu! Konstantin Gavrilovich! Yuhu!
I guess we're not going on, so I can come out. Good evening.
Bravo! Bravo!
Bravo! Bravo! Enchanting! Such beauty! Such a lovely voice! It's a sin to bury yourself here in the country. You have talent. Believe you must go on the stage.
That's the dream of my life. But it will never happen.
Who knows? Let me introduce you, Boris Alexeyevich Trigorin.
I'm so happy. I read everything you write.
Don't be shy, dear. You have such a simple soul, such a famous man right here. See how shy he is.
It's a strange play, isn't it?
I didn't understand. But I enjoy watching you. You are sincere. And the scenery was lovely. I suppose there are many fish in this lake.
Yes.
I love to fish. There's nothing I'd rather do than to sit by the water at sunset and watch a cork float.
But surely, for one who's experienced the joy of creation, no other pleasures can exist.
You shouldn't talk to him like that. He doesn't know what to say when people compliment him.
I remember one evening at the Moskva, a great Silva paid a low sea. And in a sheer coincidence, that evening, the bass from the local church orchestra was then the second ballad. And suddenly we hear, bravo Silva, a whole octave lower, just like this.
Bravo Silva.
Thunderstruck! You could hear a peep!
An angel of silence has flown over us.
I must go. Goodbye.
Where must you go? Why so soon? No, I won't let you go.
Papa's expecting me.
Oh, but a man, he's really, well, we can't help that. It's so sad to lose you.
If you only knew how much I wanted to stay.
Well, someone must see you home, darling.
No.
Don't go.
I must get your Nikolai.
Stay for just an hour. Come now, do.
I can't.
Poor girl. They say her mother left everything to her father. That was the last topic. And now he's willed everything to his second wife. Nina will be left with nothing. Shocking.
The truth is, her father's an impossible scout.
What do you say we go in? It's getting damp.
My knees, my legs.
You poor old lead steepest wood! Well, let me help you. Come along, my poor old patriarch.
Is that dog howling? Please ask him to unchain the goat in your furnace.
Cannot be done, Petrogalitich, because now we have thieves in the barn. I've stored the millet there today. Bravo, Silva! A whole octave note. And he wasn't even a concert singer, mind you. Just a simple, ordinary choir person.
How much does an ordinary choir person earn?
Oh.
Maybe I'm stupid. Maybe I'm crazy. But I like this play. There's something fresh and direct about it. She spoke of sadness. And later, when the red eyes appeared, my hands trembled. I think he's coming. I want to say nice things.
So they're all gone?
Well, I'm here.
Why should stop the words for me? What an annoying creature.
Constantine Gavrilich, I like your play very much. It's strange, and of course I didn't hear the end. But it made an impression on me. You have talent. You must write more. But how nervous you are, my friend. Tears in your eyes. What was I saying? Oh, yes. You chose an abstract idea. That's good. Art should express great ideas. Nothing can be beautiful.
Do you think I should go on?
Yes, but write only what's true and timeless. I've had a good life, very life, made good choices. But if I had the luck to experience the ecstasy of creativity, I would have soared above the earth, been carried off to the heights.
Excuse me, where's Nina?
One more thing. A work of art must have a clear, concise purpose. You must know why you write. If you merely wander down an aesthetic path, you'll lose your way, and your talent will be your downfall.
Where's Nina?
I don't know.
I have to see her. What? I want to see her. I'm going after her.
Come down, my
friend. I'm going after her, I must.
Constantine Gavrilich, your mother is worried about you. She wants to see you. Please come inside.
Tell her I've gone. And please leave me alone. All of you, leave me alone! Stop following me around.
Calm down, Costa. Don't get so excited. It's not good for you, my dear.
Goodbye, Doctor. Thank you.
Youth! Youth!
When people have nothing else to say, they say, youth, youth.
Disgusting habit.
Stop. They're playing at the house. We should go in.
Wait.
What is it?
I want to tell you something. I wanted to tell you before. I have to tell someone. I don't love my father, but you and I feel we have something in common. I don't know why, but I'm so close to you. Please help me. Help me or I do something silly. I will make a mess of my life. I will ruin it. I can't go wrong.
What's the matter? What can I do?
I'm suffering. No one knows I'm suffering. I love Constantine.
Such bundles of nerves you all are. And so much love. Ah, enchanting lake. What can I do, my dear? What?
Come stand next to me. You are 22, and I'm almost twice your age. Doctor, which of us looks younger?
You, of course.
You see, and what? Because I work, I feel, I move all the time. You stay put, you don't blink. I make it home. Not worry about the future. I don't think about aging or dying. What will be?
I drag my life along after me like a dress with an endless train. I feel 1,000 years old, and often I wish I would get. Of course it is all nonsense. I have to shake it off, pull myself together.
I am as fatigued about myself as an English duchess. I hold myself together, as they say. My hair and clothes are always comfortable. I will never leave the house in a dressing gown for my hairness. Even to come to the garden. I look young, because I am not slouching with my body. I don't let myself go, like some people do. I am light as a bird.
Well, if you don't mind, we stop at the corn merchants and the rats.
And the rats? Yes, go on.
And the rats?
Well, let me read. It's my turn. Oh. And the rats. Here we are. Thus, although it's dangerous for society people to entice novelists into their homes, and it is for corn merchants to breed rats in their granaries, nonetheless, writers in great demand. When a woman chooses a writer she wishes to capture, she lays siege to him with all manner of flattery and favors. Well, that may be true in France, but certainly not in Russia. We are not that calculating. Here a woman is already in love with a writer before she tries to capture him. Now look at me and Trigor, example.
So, we're happy now. We're happy at last. Such fun! Our father and stepmother have gone to Tver. We're free for 3 whole days.
I'm so happy. Now I'm yours.
She's looking very pretty.
Aw, neatly dressed and interestingly, what a clever girl. Where's my slick siege?
Down by the lake, fishing.
I'm amazed. He's not tired of it yet.
What are you reading?
Mopassant's on the water, dear. Well, the rest is dull and absolutely untrue. Well, I'm anxious and troubled. Tell me, what the matter with my son? Why he's so moody, so bad-tempered? He spends all days by the lake. I hardly ever see him.
He looks worried. Would you decide from his play?
If you'd like. But it's so uninteresting.
When he reads aloud, his eyes shine, and he turns pale. He has a wonderful, sad voice. He looks like a poet.
Petrusha. Dreams.
Petrusha, are you sleeping?
No.
It's so silly of you, dear, not to take medicine.
I want to take medicine. The doctor won't give me any.
You're always at 60.
Even at 60, one wants to live.
Oh, all right. Take some valerian.
Maybe you should go to a spa.
Well, then let him go to a spa if he wants. Or not if he doesn't.
What does it mean?
Just what I said, Claire.
I think Peter Nikolaevich should give up smoking.
Nonsense!
No, it's not nonsense. Alcohol and tobacco rob us of ourselves. When you drink and smoke, you're not just Peter Nikolaevich anymore, you're Peter Nikolaevich with someone else. You begin to think of yourself not as me, but as him, a third person.
It's easy for you to talk. You've had a good life. I haven't lived. I spent 28 years in the law court. I haven't experienced a thing. You've had gold. You're satisfied. It's easy for you to be detached. You've had it all. I have to enjoy myself now. That's why I drink sherry after dinner, smoke cigars, and so on. That's why.
The way to live is good. But wanting to go to spas, to take cures at 60, and complaining you didn't enjoy your youth, well, that, forgive me, is just silly.
You talk like someone who's happy.
Well, now's the time for lunch. My legs are asleep.
You have 2 vodkas before lunch.
It's the only pleasure she has in life.
Nonsense, Your Excellency.
You talk like a man who's had it.
Well,
What could be more boring than this boring country life? It's hot and humid. Everyone philosophizes. Well, it's lovely to be here with you, my friends. And lovely to hear you talk. But how much more lovely to be alone in my hotel room, learning my part.
Oh yes, I know just what you mean.
Of course it's better in town. I mean, you have servants to where you sit in your study, a servant waits on you, announces your visitors. You have a telephone, there are taxis in the street, and so forth.
At a hotel, my flowers.
Oh, here they are! Good morning. I am delighted to see that you're looking so well, dear lady. My wife tells me that you wish to go to town with her today. Is that true?
Yes, we are going into town.
Very glad. How do you propose to go there? We are carting right today. The men are busy in the field. What horses can I spare?
What horses? How should I know what horses?
The carriage horses, of course.
Carriage? Horses? Where am I to get colors? You're an extraordinary, unbelievable. Dear lady, I kneel in front of you, darling. I will gladly give you 10 years of my life. I cannot give you any horses.
But if I have to go into town, isn't that a bit odd?
This is fantastic. Dear lady, you have no idea how to run a farm.
It's the same old story. Well, then I return to Moscow. Today, go and hire some horses in the village, or I will walk into station.
Fine. Now you resign. Find yourself a new manager.
The same old story. Every summer, I'm insulted. I shall never set foot here again.
This is impossible. I want all the horses brought here right now.
To refuse the famous actress Irina Nikolaevna, it's incredible. Her slightest whim matters more than all of your silly farming.
What am I supposed to do? Put yourself in my position. What am I supposed to do?
Come, we'll find my sister. We'll plead with her not to go, won't we? That man is impossible, a tyrant.
This is terrible.
Yes, it's terrible. He won't put up with it. I'll give him a piece of my mind.
People are tiresome. Osmond, of course, should have been 5 years ago. But in the end, it'll be that old woman, Peter Nikolaevich, and her sister will apologize.
He sends the carriage horses into the fields, of course. Every day, it's something else. If you only knew how it makes me feel, it makes me ill. Look, I'm trembling. I cannot bear his coarseness. Oh, Evgeny, my dearest darling, please take me away with you. Our time is passing. We're not young anymore. If only before the end of our days we could stop hiding, stop lying.
I'm 55. It's too late for me to change how I live.
I see, of course. There are other women, and you can't take us all home. You can't live with us all. I'm sorry that I bothered you. You must be very, very tired of me.
No, it's all right.
I'm always jealous. I suffer from jealousy. I know that a doctor can't avoid ugly. I understand.
Well, what's happening in there?
Irina Nikolaevna is crying.
Oh.
And Peter Nikolaevich is having an asthma attack.
I'll go give them some valerian.
For you?
Ah, merci bien.
Oh, what lovely flowers. Yeah. Give them to me. Oh, give them to me.
How strange a famous actress should cry over such a small thing. How strange a famous writer, everyone's favorite, mentioned every day in the papers, his picture everywhere, his books translated, should spend whole days fishing by the lake. I thought that famous people were proud and unapproachable, that they had contempt for everyone else, and that they used their fame to revenge themselves against the world for having placed wealth and rank ahead of them. But they seemed to cry, laugh, fish, play cards, and lose their tempers, just like everyone else.
Are you alone?
Yes. What does that mean?
I was vile enough to kill the seagull today. I laid at your feet.
What's the matter with you?
I'll kill myself the same way soon.
I hardly recognize you.
I hardly recognize you. You've changed toward me. Your eyes were cold. My presence seems to embarrass you.
You're so irritable lately. And you talk in riddles. Like this. This seagull. What is it? A symbol? Sorry, but I don't understand it. I'm afraid I'm too simple to understand you.
This all began the night my play failed, didn't it? Women don't forgive failure. I wrote the play, down to the last page. If you only knew how unhappy I am. You were being called to me, it's terrible. It's unbelievable. It's as if I'd woken up and found the lake dry or sunk into the earth. And you say you're too simple to understand me. But what is there to understand? My play failed. So you don't like my work. You think I'm worthless and unimportant, so everybody else does. I understand that. I understand it only too well. It's like a nail pounding into my head. And to hell with it. And to hell with my pride, which sucks my blood like a leech. Oh, here comes real genius. He walks like Hamlet. And with the book, too. Words, words, words. The sun is but to appear, you're smiling. The coldness in your eyes melts with its warmth. Oh, I won't stand in your way.
Take snuff. Drink vodka. Always wears black. Schoolmaster is in love with her.
Good morning, Boris Alexeyevich.
Morning. Thanks for taking a turn. I'm afraid we're leaving today. You and I are not likely to meet again. I'm sorry. You don't often meet young, charming girls. Forget what it is to be 18 or 19. I can't visualize it. That's why all the young women in my stories and novels are unconvincing. I'd like to be in your shoes for just an hour. See through your eyes. Know what you think. Know what kind of person you are.
I'd like to be in your shoes.
Why?
To know how it feels to be famous. What is it like being famous? How does it make you feel?
How? I don't know. I've never really thought about it. One of two things. Either you exaggerate my fame, or I just don't feel it much.
It's an amazing world. If you only knew how I envy you. Most people live miserable, frustrating lives, each just like the next. All terribly unhappy, while some, like you, are one in a million. It is your fate to live a bright, fascinating, worthwhile life. You must be very happy.
Me? Fame, happiness, a fascinating life? Forgive me, but those words are about as meaningful to me as sugar plums, which I don't eat. Break up.
You have a beautiful life.
What's so beautiful about it? I have to get back to work. Excuse me, I'm going in. You stepped on my toes. You've made me angry and excited. So let's talk. Let's talk about my bright, beautiful life. Where shall we begin? You know how it is with obsession? Well, the moon, for instance. Day and night, someone thinks only of the moon. Well, I have a moon. Day and night, I'm obsessed. I must write, I must write, I must write. I barely finish a novel when I must begin another one. And then a third, and a fourth. I write without stopping, at lightning speed. It's the only way I can write. What's bright and beautiful about that? I talk to you, and I'm excited. But I can't forget the unfinished story waiting on my desk. I see that cloud. It's shaped like a grand piano. Instantly, I take note. A cloud sailed by like a grand piano. The smell of heliotrope. I take note. A sickly smell. The widow's color. I'll use it to capture a summer's evening. I capture every word we say. Lock it away in my literary storeroom. Who knows when it'll be useful? I finish work and rush to the theater, officially, hoping to find some rest, but no, a new idea drops into my head like a cannon, and I'm back at my desk, writing, writing, writing. I have no rest. I consume my life. To obtain honey for strangers, I rob my best blossoms of their pollen, tear them up, trample them. You think I'm crazy? Well, do people talk to me as if I were sane? What are you writing now? What masterpiece will you give us next? As for my young years, my best years, life was a torture. A young writer, especially an unlucky one, feels awkward and unwanted. The world doesn't need him. His nerves are frazzled. He's always on edge. But he can't resist being around people in the arts and literature. They, of course, ignore him. They have no use for him. He's like an incurable gambler with no money. I was deathly afraid of theater audiences. They terrified me. Whenever a new play of mine would open up, I would look out in the audience and think the dark-haired people in the audience were hostile. The blondes was cold and indifferent. It was horrible. Torture.
But surely, when you're inspired and creating, you must have moments of great ecstasy.
Yes, I enjoy writing and reading proofs. But as soon as something's published, I hate it. I see it's not what I meant. I feel angry. I feel bad. And other people read it. Yes, they say. Charming and clever, but a far cry from Tolstoy. Or, it was good, but Turgenev's Fathers and Sons was better. Until I die, they'll say, charming and clever, nothing more. And on my tombstone, they'll write, here lies Trigorin, a good writer, but not as good as Turgenev.
Forgive me, but I think you've been spoiled by success.
What success? I don't like my life, and I don't like my work. I think in the end, all I can really write about are landscapes. About everything else, I'm false. False to the core.
You don't have the time or the wish to realize the importance of what you write. But others consider you to be a great man. If I were a writer like you, I would give my life to the people. I would know that they could only be happy by raising themselves to my level. And I'd permit them to draw my chariot.
A chariot? See me as Agamemnon.
For the glory of being a writer or an actress, I'd endure anything. The disapproval of my family and friends, poverty, disappointment. I'd live in a garret, eat dry bread, and agonize over my limitations. But in return, I would demand fame, real, resounding fame. My head is spinning.
Paris Alexeyevich!
She's calling me. It's time to pack. But I don't want to leave. Glorious! What
Constantine Gavrilich shot it.
It's a beautiful bird. I don't want to leave. Try to convince Irina Nikolaevna to stay.
What are you writing?
And just a note, an idea for a short story came to my head. A young woman, like you, lives her whole life by a lake. She loves the lake, as a seagull loves it. She's happy and free as a seagull. But by chance, one day, a man comes along, sees her, and having nothing better to do, destroys her like a seagull.
Boris Alexeyevich, where are you?
Coming. What is it?
We are staying.
It's a dream. I tell you this because you are a writer. You can use it if you want. It is the truth. If he died when he shot himself, I wouldn't have lived another moment. But I became a braver. I've made up my mind. I shall have good luck from my heart.
How are you doing?
I shall marry Medvedenko.
The schoolmaster?
Yes.
I don't understand. Is that necessary?
Loving and hoping year after year. What's the point? When I'm married, there will be no time for love. New worries will make me forget. Anyway, it will be a change, won't it? Shall we have another?
Haven't we had enough?
No. Don't look at me like that. More women drink than you think, but most of them don't drink as openly as I do. They drink in secret. Yes, and always vodka or cognac. Your health. You're nice. Easy to get along with.
Don't want to go.
Then ask her to stay.
No, she won't do that. Her son behaves tactlessly. First he tries to shoot himself. Now it appears he wants to challenge me to a duel. Why? He sulks, snorts, and preaches about new art forms. There's room for all forms of art. Why does she show?
He's jealous, of course. That is none of my business. My schoolmaster is not smart. But he's kind. He's poor. He loves me. He needs me. I feel sorry for him and his old mother. Well, I wish you luck. I'm so grateful for your friendship. Think kindly of me. Don't forget to send me your books and autograph them. But please don't write with best wishes. Write to Masha. He doesn't know where she's from or why she's alive.
Odd or even?
Even?
No. I only have one P in my hand. I want to know if I should become an actress or not. I want someone to tell me.
Only you can tell you.
You're leaving. We'll probably never see each other again. So I'd like to present you with this little medallion. I have your initials engraved on it. And on the other side, the title of your book, Days and Nights.
What a beautiful thing to do. Beautiful gift.
Think of me sometimes.
I will. I'll think of you on that sunny day. Do you remember we talked? There was a white seagull.
Yes, a seagull. Someone's coming. Let me see you for just 2 minutes before you leave, please.
Stay home, Petrusha. With your rheumatism, you shouldn't be running about paying visits. Who just went out? Nina?
Yes.
Sorry, we intruded. I think I've packed everything. I'm exhausted.
Days and nights, in 121 lines, 11 and 12.
Should I pack your fishing rod, sir?
Yes, I'll want them, but give away the books.
Yes.
Days and nights, page 121 lines, 11 and 12. Do you have my books in this house?
Yes, in my brother's study, the corner bookcase.
Page 121.
Really, Petrusha, I think you should stay home.
You're leaving? It's lonely without you here.
But what are there to do in town?
Nothing, of course. They are laying the cornerstone for the new council house and so on. I've been lying around like an old pipe. I need to turn myself about somehow. I've wanted the horses for one. What do you do again?
All right. But don't be too bored when you return. You have to go and live in here, you know? Try to avoid catching cold. And take care, Constantine. Advise him. While I'm living, I don't even know why he tried to kill himself. I suppose it's jealousy. The sooner I take you going away from here, the better.
I don't know. There may be other reasons than that. You see, he's a bright young man with no money, no position, and no future. He has nothing to do. He's ashamed of that and frightened of it. I love him very much, and I think he loves me too, but he feels superfluous in this house, like a dependent, a poor relation. We can understand that, you and I. It's pride.
Oh, this boy is such a worry to me. He should get himself a job in the civil service, or something.
It wouldn't be so bad if you were to give him a little money. I mean, I think he should have a decent set of clothes. He's been wearing that same jacket for 3 years, and he doesn't have an overcoat. And it wouldn't be so bad for a young man to have a little fun sat now and again. Maybe go abroad for a while. That wouldn't cost much, would it?
I don't know. I think I can afford a new suit, but going abroad is out of the question. Well, I don't think I can afford even a suit right now. I don't have any money. I don't!
Don't get angry with me, my dear. I believe you. You're a generous, warm-hearted woman.
I don't have any money.
If I had any, I would give it to him. But I don't. Not a copeck. Shabriev takes my pension and spends it all on the farm, raising cattle and bees. That's where my money goes. And then the cows die, and the damn bees die. And when I need a carriage, the horses are not being used elsewhere.
Of course I have some money, but I'm an actress. The cost of my costumes is enough to ruin me.
You're a generous, warm-hearted woman. I respect you, I do.
I'm afraid I don't feel so well. My head is swimming. Oh, I feel funny.
Petrusha! Oh, Petrusha, someone help!
Something's coming over me.
He's feeling faint.
It's nothing, really. It's nothing. Oh, it's going away. It's over.
Don't worry, Mama. Uncle often has these attacks now. You must go lie down, Uncle.
I'll lie down, but then I'm going to town. I'll lie down. I'm going to town. Is that clear?
Have you heard this riddle, sir? What goes on 4 legs in the morning, 2 at noon, 3 in the evening, and...
And at night lies on its back. Yes, I've heard that thing. I can manage alone. Thank you.
No need to stand on ceremony with me, sir.
He frightened me.
It's not good for him to live in the country. He doesn't feel well here. You certainly felt generous, Mama, loaned him $1,002. He could spend a whole year in town.
I don't have any money. I'm an actress, not a banker.
Will you bandage me up, please? You do so well.
The doctor is late today.
Yes, he said he'd be here at 10, so it's noon.
Sit down. You look like you're wearing a turban. Yesterday, someone in the kitchen asked your nationality. Look, the wound is almost.
won't do anything like this again when I'm gone, will you?
No, Mama. It was just a moment of crazy despair. I couldn't control myself. It won't happen again. You've got golden hands, Mama. When you were still playing in the public theaters, there was a fight once in our courtyard. One of the tenants, a washerwoman, was beaten almost to death. Do you remember that? She was unconscious when they picked her up, and you nursed her, and you brought her medicine, and then you washed her children in a tub. Don't you remember that?
No.
And two ballerinas lived in that house, too, and you invited them for coffee.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. Well, they're awfully pious, weren't they? These past few days, Mama, I've loved you as innocently and fully as a child. I've only you now. But why do you allow yourself to fall under the spell of that man?
You don't understand him, Constantine. He is a noble character.
What he heard us when I challenged him to a duel. That noble character turned into a coward. He's leaving. Ignominious retreat.
Nonsense. I asked him to leave.
You and I almost quarrel about it here. He's probably making fun of us in the drawing room or the garden, expanding Nina's mind, convincing her he's a genius.
You like to say disagreeable things to me. Well, I like that man. I respect this man, and I'll ask you not to speak badly of him in my presence.
Well, I don't respect him. You want me to think he's a genius? Well, I'm sorry, I can't lie about it. His books make me sick.
Well, this is just envy. People who have pretensions to talent always try to insult genius. It must be comforting to you.
Genius? Mm-hmm. I have more genius than any of you when it comes to that. Oh. You and he and your boring ideas. You control the arts. You won't recognize or tolerate anything but your own superficial notions. No, you sit on and suppress everything else. Well, I don't respect your high artistic opinions of yourselves. I don't respect his, and I don't respect yours.
Well, you're a dividend.
Well, then go back to your precious theater. Go act in your precious third-rate plays.
I have never acted in trashy third-rate plays. Why don't you just leave me alone? You can't even write a cheap vaudeville sketch. No. Little bourgeois from Kiev. Little sponger!
Miser!
Beggar! Little nobody! Don't cry! Don't! Forgive me, please! Forgive me, you're my close mother! I'm such a miserable person! Please forgive me!
If you only knew I lost everything. She doesn't love me now. I can't write. It's hopeless.
Don't feel that way. Everything will work out. He's leaving today. She'll love you again. That's enough. We meet up now, huh?
Yes, Mama.
We'll make up with him, too. You don't really want to duel, do you? It's so silly.
All right, Mom. All right. Just don't let me see him again. That would be too much. I'm gonna bear it. He's coming. So I'll go. The doctor will manage me in the house.
121, lines 11 and 12. If you should ever need my life, come and take it.
The horses will be here soon.
If you should ever need my life, come and take it.
Are you packed?
Yes. Why do those words from a pure heart make me sad? If you should ever need my life, come and take it. Let's stay another day. Let's stay!
Darling, I know why you want to stay. But try to control yourself. You're a little drunk. Be sober.
You be sober. Be wise and understanding. You're capable of sacrifice. Be a true friend. Be my friend. Free me.
Are you that infatuated?
I'm drawn to her. Maybe she's just what I need.
The love of a little country girl. How little you know yourself.
Sometimes people are talking, but they're asleep. That's how I feel right now.
I'm talking, but I'm asleep, dreaming of her. Such sweet, beautiful dreams. Please let me go.
No. No! I'm an ordinary woman, Doris. You mustn't talk to me like that. Don't torture me. I'm frightened.
If you wanted, you could be extraordinary. There's a kind of love, a young love, that sweeps you into a world of dreams. It's all poetry and beauty. I've never known that kind of love. When I was young, I was too busy running around to publishers, trying to make a living. But now it's come. It's here. It's calling. Why should I run from it?
You're out of your mind!
Well, what if I am?
You're all against me today. You're trying to torment me. It's a conspiracy.
She doesn't understand. She doesn't want to understand.
Am I so old? I'm ugly. You can talk about other women in front of me like that? Oh, you're mad. My beautiful lover. My divine lover. The last chapter of my life. My joy. My pride. My happiness. If you leave me, even for an hour, I won't survive. I'll go out of my mind. My magnificent. My divine. My master.
Someone coming.
Well, let them. I'm not ashamed of my love for you. My reckless boy, my precious boy. You want to destroy yourself, but I won't let you. You're mine, mine, mine. Oh, this forehead is mine. These eyes are mine. This beautiful silken hair of mine. You're all mine. You're so talented, so clever. You're the greatest writer alive. You are the only hope of Russia. You write with such sincerity, such simplicity. One stroke of your pen, and you go straight to the heart of the character. Oh, please. People in your books are so alive. To read you is a triumphant experience.
You think I'm exaggerating?
Why? Look at my eyes. Now go and look at them. I'm the only person who really appreciates you. I'm the only one who tells you the truth. Oh, my magnificent, my divine, my darling, you'll come with me, will you? You will never leave me, will you?
I have no will of my own. I've never had a will of my own. I'm flabby and weak, I always submit. How could any woman love me? Oh. Take me away, carry me off, and don't let me out of your sight for a moment.
He is mine. Of course, if you want to go by yourself, you can. I'll go by myself and you can come some other day.
No.
There's no reason for you to hurry.
I might as well go with you.
Whatever you say.
If you want to go together, we will. What are you writing?
A phrase I heard this morning. It'll be useful. The chaste forest. I like that. So we're going. Once more to the railway carriage, stations, station buffets, more stews and conversations.
I have the honor to announce, dear madame, great regret. The horses are here. It's time to go to the station. We will be here in 5 minutes. After two!
Dear lady, would you please inquire about the actor?
He was wonderful in the stolen play. We had a drink once together, even in the same theater company. He was another great actor.
Dear lady, no worry, you still have 5 minutes.
Whereas they were playing, they were spreaders, you know, the melodrama. When they were discovered, Ismailov was supposed to say, "We were caught in a trap." But instead he said, "We were caught in a trap! We were caught in a trap!"
I bought you some plums for the journey. They're very sweet. Thought you might like them on the train.
Thank you, Bogdan Andreevna. You're very kind.
Yes. Bye, my dear. If there's anything that has not been quite right, please forgive it.
Everything
have to leave. I'm going to the carriage.
I'll walk to the station. If I walk fast enough, I'll be there in time to see you off.
Goodbye, my dears. Probably we'll see each other next summer.
Well, don't forget me. Here's the ruble. That's for the three of you.
Thank you, madame. We're very grateful.
God bless you. And don't forget, dear lady, please drop us a line every now and then. What is it, Sage?
Where's Constantine? Tell him I'm leaving now to say goodbye to him. Jakob, I gave Cook a ruble. That's for the three of you.
Thank you, madam. I forgot my stick. I think it's on the terrace.
It's you. We're just leaving.
I knew we'd meet again. Boris Alexeyevich, I've decided the die is cast. I'm running away. I'm going on the stage. Tomorrow I won't be here. I'm leaving my father, everything. Like you, I'm going to Moscow. We'll meet there.
Stay at the hotel Slavyansky Bazaar. Let me know as soon as you arrive. Olchanka Grahovsky House.
Go. Just one moment longer.
You're so lovely. I'm glad we'll be together again soon. I'll see those wonderful eyes of yours. That sweet, tender smile, that dear face. So angelic and pure.
Doesn't help.
My heart aches for you. I see. it all. I understand it too well.
It is nonsense, Mama. I'm requited love is something you read about in novels. It is natural. I won't sit around brooding anymore, hoping for something that won't happen, since I am foolish enough to have fallen in love. I just have to fall out of it, that is all. My husband been promised to transfer to another district. When we're there, I'll forget love. I'll tear it out of my heart, roots at home.
Costa's playing. He must be feeling sad.
Mother, I have to live somewhere where I can't see him. When they give Simon his transfer, I forget love. In a month. It's too soon.
Now I have 6 mouths to feed and flowers at 2 kopecks a pound.
Well, it flows, huh?
You can joke about it. You'll have more money than you know what to do with. You're rolling in it.
Rolling? After 30 years of practicing medicine, on call, day and night, do you know, my friend, how much I managed to save? 2,000 rubles. I just spent them on my trip abroad. I have nothing.
Haven't you gone yet?
How can I go? Your father won't give me a horse.
I wish I never laid eyes on you.
I see you made some changes, turned the city room into a study.
Yes. Constantine Gavrilovich likes to work here. He can go into the garden to think anytime he likes.
Where's my sister?
She went to the station to meet your father. She'll be back soon.
If you called for my sister, then I must be very sick. So if I'm very sick, why won't you give me medicine?
What you want then? Valerian, soda, quinine.
You're preaching again. You're so difficult. Is that for me?
Yes, Peter Nikolai, it's for you.
Thank you. I have an idea for a story for Kostya. The man who wanted Lam Kiavulu. You see, when I was young, I wanted to be a writer, but I never became one. I wanted to be eloquent in court, but I'm hopeless in public speaking. On the other hand, I could go on like that for hours in a sweat. I wanted to marry, but I didn't. I wanted to live in town, and here I am ending my life in the country, and so forth.
You wanted to be a civil counselor, you became.
No, I never wanted to be a civil counselor. It just happened.
To quarrel with life when you reach age 62, it's ungrateful, don't you think?
You're so stubborn. Can't you understand a person wanting to live?
Yes, but it's irrational. It's a law of nature that every life must end.
You talk like a man who's had everything. You've satisfied your appetites. It's easy for you to be philosophical. Even so, you too will be afraid when you're dying.
Fear of death is an animal fear. You have to overcome it. Only religious people have a real reason to be afraid. They believe in life after death. You're afraid to be punished for their sins. That's not your case. You're not religious, and you've committed no sin, except to serve in the ministry of justice for 25 years.
28.
We're keeping Constantine Gavrilovich from his work.
Doesn't matter.
Doctor, might I ask which city you most prefer to run?
Genoa. Why Genoa?
Because of the marvelous crowds in the streets. In the evening when you leave your hotel, the streets swarm with people. You could drift among them aimlessly, live their lives. But with the soul of the crowds pouring into you, you start to feel there might really be a wounded spirit. Like the one Nina Sarichna performed in your play. By the way, where is this? How is she?
I suppose she's well.
Well, someone told me she was leading a strange life. What do they mean by
that? Long story, Doctor.
Well, shorten it!
She ran away from home and had an affair with DeVore. You knew that, didn't you?
Yes, I knew that.
She had a child, the child died. DeVore tired of going back to his old attachments, which might have been expected.
On the stage?
Even worse, it seems.
made her debut in a small summer theater near Moscow. Then she toured the provinces. I never lost sight of her. Everywhere she went, I followed. She always played major roles, but her acting was crude. When she lacked subtlety, she tended to rant. Her gestures were stiff. At moments, she still showed some talent. She screamed well, and she died well. That's all, but only moments.
But at least she had some talent.
I don't know. It's hard to tell. I suppose she must have. I saw her, but she wouldn't see me. Her maid at the hotel turned me away. I understood Nina's feelings. I didn't insist. What more can I tell you? Now, afterward, when I got home, she wrote to me, and her letters were warm and sensible and interesting. She never complained, but I can tell she was terribly unhappy. She even seemed a little unbalanced. And I'm always signing herself a Seagull. Now she's here.
Well, what do you mean here?
Well, she's in town at the inn. She's been here for 5 days. I went and sorted Masha, but she won't see anyone. Semyon Semyonovich, this is our last night in the field about an hour from town.
Yes, I saw her. She was walking towards town. I bowed to her. I asked her why she had come to see us. She said she would.
She won't. Her father and stepmother have nothing to do with her. They posted guards around their estate, so she won't come near the house. It's easy to be a philosopher and paper doctor, but hard in life.
She was a beautiful girl.
What's that?
I said she was a beautiful girl. State Councilor Soren himself was once in love with her for a little while.
They're back from the station.
Yes, I hear mother.
We all age and fade like leaves in the fall. Except you, of course, gracious lady. Always looking young, wearing white, bright colors.
Dreadful man, you want to bring me bad luck?
How are you, Gachechiladze? Are you still sick? That's not good. Ah, Mashinka.
So you remember me?
Are you married?
A long time now.
Are you happy? Excuse me. Irina Nikolaevna tells me you're not angry with me anymore. You forgot
Look,
the past.
But it's an exchange brought your literary review with your new story in it.
Thank you, that's very kind of you.
Your public sends you greetings. In Petersburg and Moscow, people are very interested in your work. They ask me about you. What's he like? How does he look? Is he old? Does he have dark hair or is he blonde? Oddly enough, people think you're old. And nobody knows your real name. Why do you write under a pseudonym? You're as mysterious as the man in the Iron Mask.
Will you be staying long?
No. I've got to go to Moscow tomorrow. I want to finish my novel. And I've promised something for an anthology. It's always the same with me. The weather's not welcoming. The wind is fierce. If it dies down tomorrow, I'll fish in the lake. I want to walk around the garden, the place where your play was done. Do you remember? I've got an idea for a short story. I want to remind myself where it takes place.
Papa, would you give my husband a horse? He has to go home.
A horse? He has to go home? Can't you understand that horses just came back from the station? You cannot go back in this weather.
But there aren't the only horses. You're impossible.
Really, Masha, I can walk.
Walk in this weather? Well, everyone come, let's play.
Oh, well, it's only 6 miles. Goodbye. Goodbye, Mother. I wouldn't have troubled anyone if it weren't for the baby. Goodbye.
He'll make it. He's not a general after all. He can walk.
Well, friends, let's not waste any more time. They'll be calling us into supper soon. During long autumn evenings, here we play a little. This is the lotus that our mother told us was made when we were children. It's not a thrilling game, but it's pretty pleasant when you're accustomed to it.
He's read his own story, but he hasn't even cut the pages of mine.
What about you, Kostya?
No, thanks, Mom. I don't feel like it. I'm going for a walk.
Well, everybody put 10 copics into the bag. Put my name for me, Doctor.
Absolutely.
Is everyone in?
Yeah.
I will start.
to run?
Slow down! Slow down!
Oh, they love me, Piper. My head is still spinning.
34.
They could be students. They gave me an ovation. 3 baskets of flowers, 2 bouquets, and look, this brooch.
Ooh, very impressive.
55.
55, you say?
Oh, I had a fabulous costume. You must admit, I know how to dress.
Constantina's plague again. That poor boy has been very unhappy.
Yes, the newspapers weren't very kind to him.
77.
You shouldn't pay attention to that.
He's had no luck. He can't seem to find a style of his own. There's something vague and strange about his writing. Never a single living character.
11.
Petrusha, are you bored?
State Councilor Sorin is asleep.
Do you think that if I lived by a lake that I would write, I would not? I would conquer that passion and do nothing but fish.
26.
Catching a perch is my idea of heaven.
Well, I for one believe in Constantine Gavrilich. He has something. He thinks in images. His stories are striking, full of color. I find them moving. I'm only sorry he doesn't write with more purpose. He creates powerful emotional impressions. That's nothing. Irina Nikolaevna, are you pleased your son's arriving?
Can you imagine? I haven't read anything he's written. There's never any time.
28.
Boris Alexeyevich, we have something of yours over here.
What is it?
Konstantin Gavrilich has shot in a seagull once and you asked us to stop it.
I don't remember.
66.
I don't know why I feel so restless.
Kostya, shut the window. There's a draft.
88.
My game, ladies and gentlemen.
Bravo! Bravo! Bravo!
It is the man who's lucky in everything. And now let's go and eat. Our famous writer hasn't ate anything for the whole day. And we'll play the game later. Kostya, why don't you stop bribing and let's go have some supper?
I don't want supper, Mother. I'm not hungry.
Whatever you say. Petrusha, it's time for supper. And now, let me tell you about the ovation I had in Pyka.
I've talked and I've talked about creating new forms, but little by little I'm falling into a pattern myself. The poster proclaimed a pale face framed by dark hair, Carl was right. Dwarf style set. He's got it easy. You know, more and more I think it's not a question of new forms, or old forms, but what matters is to allow what you write to come straight from your heart. What's that? Who's there?
Nina, it's you. You, I knew it. All day my heart's been pounding. My darling one.
Don't cry.
There's someone here.
No, there's no one.
Lock the door, someone might come in.
No one will come in.
I know Irina Nikolaevna is here. Lock the doors.
Don't be afraid. No one will come.
Let me look at you. It's warm here. Cozy. This used to be the drawing room. Am I very much changed?
Yes. You're thinner. Your eyes are larger. It's strange to be actually looking at you. Nina, why didn't you let me see you? Why didn't you come here? You've been at the inn nearly a week. I've been there every day. I stood on your window with a letter.
I was afraid you might hate me. I dream every night that you look at me and don't recognize me. If you only knew. Ever since I've been back here, I've been walking about by the lake. I've been near your house often, but I couldn't make up my mind to come in. It's warm here. Cozy. Shh. Do you hear the wind? There's a place in Turgenev. Happy is he who on such a night under his own roof, who has a warm corner. A seagull! No, that is not it. What was I saying? Yes, Turgenev. And may the Lord help all homeless wanderers.
Nina, you're crying again.
It's nothing. It's nothing. It will make me feel better. I have not cried for 2 years. Last night I came to the garden to see whether our theater was still there. And it was there still. I cried for the first time in 2 years. And my heart grew lighter. And my soul was clearer. Look, I'm not crying now. You are an author. And I am an actress. We've both been drawn into the whirlpool. I used to be happy as a child. I used to wake up in the morning singing. I loved you, and I dreamed of being famous. And now, tomorrow early I must go to Yelitz, in the third class with peasants. And in Yelitz, the cultured merchants will plague me with their attentions. Life is brutal.
Why go to Yelitz?
I've taken an engagement for the winter. It's time I was going.
Nina, I've cursed and I've hated you. I tore up your letters and photographs, but I knew I belonged to you. My heart is yours, I can't stop loving you. And since I lost you, my work has begun to be published. Life has been agony. It's as if my youth had been snatched away. I feel like I'm 90. You know, I've called your name and I've kissed the ground where you walked. Everywhere I go, I see your face and your smile and the days when I was happy.
Why does he talk like that? Why does he talk like that?
I'm lonely. I'm cold. No love warms me. I feel like I'm living in a dungeon. You know, everything I write is dry and harsh and gloomy. Please stay, Nina.
Don't see me off.
For God's sake.
My horses are just...
Where are you going now?
To town. Is Irina Nikolaevna here?
Yes, my uncle had an attack on Thursday. We telegraphed her to come.
Why do you say that you kiss the ground that I walk on?
I'm lonely.
I ought to be killed.
I'm lonely. I'm cold.
I'm so tired.
I feel like I'm living in a dungeon.
If only I could rest. I am a seagull. No, that is not it. I am an actress. One more matter. And he's here too. Well, no matter. He doesn't believe in the theater. All of my dreams he would laugh at until little by little I stopped believing in it myself and I lost heart. And there was this string of love and jealousy. Constant anxiety about my little baby. I became trashy and small, and I couldn't think when I was playing. I didn't know what to do with my hands. I couldn't stand properly on the stage. I couldn't control my voice. You can't imagine the feeling when you are acting and you know that it is bad. I am a seagull. No, that is not it. Do you remember when you shot a seagull? A man comes by chance, and he sees it. And with nothing else to do, he destroys it! No, that's not it. What was I talking about? Oh, yes. I was talking about the stage. Now I'm not like that. I am a real actress. I act with delight and with rapture. I feel drunk when I am on the stage. And I feel that I am beautiful. And ever since I've come back here, I've kept walking and thinking and believing that my soul is growing stronger every day. And now I know. Kostya, I understand that in our work, whether it is acting or whether it is writing, what matters is not fame, and it is not glory,
not those things that I used to dream about. It is how to endure, to bear my cross, and to have faith. I do have faith, and it all doesn't hurt me so much anymore. And when I think of my calling, I am not afraid of my life.
You found your way, and you know where you're going. I'm still living in dreams and images. No, I can't make sense of them. I don't know what or who it's all for. I have no faith and no calling.
I'm going. Goodbye. When I am a great actress, will you come and see me perform? Do you promise? But now it's late. I can hardly stand on my feet. I'd like something to eat.
I'll bring you supper.
So, she brought him along with her. But that's all one. When you see Trigorin, don't ever tell him anything. I love him. I love him even more than before. An ideal for a short story. I love passionately. I love to desperation. How nice it used to be, Kostya. Do you remember? How happy and warm and pure our lives were. The things that we felt. Tender, delicate, like flowers. Do you remember? Men and beasts. Lions, eagles, and partridges. Antler deer. Mute fishes dwelling in the water, starfish and small creatures, invisible to the eye. These and all life have run their sad course and are no more. Vainly now the pallid moon doth light her lamp. In the meadows the cranes wake and cry no longer. And the beetle's hum is silent in the linden groves.
I hope nobody sees her in the garden and tells Mama. Mama wouldn't like that.
Absolutely, of course.
Would be wine and beer for Blaise Lysage here. We'll drink as we place it down, my friends.
Bring the tea in as well.
This is what I was talking about, Blaise Lysage. As you requested. What up?
I don't remember.
My medicine case, something probably exploded. Don't worry. Just as I thought, a bottle of ether blew up. It's more I stand before you.
I was so frightened. It reminded me of everything went dark for a moment.
Two months ago, there was an article in this review, a letter from America. By the way, I want to ask you, because I'm very interested in this question. Get Irina Nikolaevna away from here. Konstantin Gavrilovich has just shot himself.